genocide there that is going on over the mineral wealth of that country. Well, everything that is happening from South Africa to DRC, Zimbabwe, and many other countries that our beautiful, friendly white people have set their foot at. Hundreds of thousands of people have died the minute white people set their foot there. Only for one reason, for the mineral wealth of those countries. So in West Papua, it is said that 500,000 people have died then. We don't know now how many hundreds others have been killed ever since the last statistics has been done. We know for a fact that when white people set their foot in America, millions of indigenous people died only for one reason, mineral wealth of that country.
Organisasi Papua Merdeka atau OPM telah berjuang selama 20 tahun lebih berperang dengan pemerintah maupun tentara Indonesia. Dengan hanya memakai alat-alat tradisional kita, yaitu panah busur, tombak, dan lain-lain. Tetapi, bila pasukan kami atau OPM diperlengkapi dengan peralatan militer, bisa berhadapan dengan tentara Indonesia karena medan-medan di rimba dapat dikuasai oleh OPM. Jadi sudah ada kemungkinan-kemungkinan untuk kita bisa segera mencapai tujuan kemerdekaan bagi bangsa Papua.
The genocide in West Papua is happening because of the gold. It is said that West Papua is the biggest gold reserve in the world. Yeah? And so Indonesia is just a, what is this thing? There's a beautiful English word. Indonesia is just a front for American interest. Who really benefits from the death and the blood in West Papua? It's America. And if you can really research as to who really benefits from the destruction of the mineral wealth of DRC, it is the imperialist country, America. Yeah? And if you also follow exactly what, throughout other countries as to who really benefits from the mineral wealth and the destruction of nature and the human beings there, again, it is the Western white world. So today we can clearly say that white people are the beneficiary of the genocide in West Papua.
Ada beberapa kelompok golongan dari masyarakat Indonesia yang mempunyai ide berbeda dengan ide Pancasila. Salah satu diantaranya adalah ide separatis yang ingin mungkin mewujudkan suatu negara baru, Melanesia Barat atau organisasi Papua Merdeka yang sebetulnya suatu mimpi yang tidak mungkin terjadi, tidak mungkin terwujud di wilayah Republik Indonesia yang sudah menjadi satu ini.
When we stand against the genocide in West Papua, we should directly link it to the genocide that is going on in what is this country? In DRC, the genocide that is still going on in Haiti today, the genocide that went on and still going on in the Americas, because you see, the unfortunate part of it is that when these people set foot in your country, do not think that bloodshed will only stop when they take over your country. They make sure Uti, blood continues. I think the Western white system does not get satisfied with just taking over your country, your culture, and your identity. It is sustained through the blood of the local people of that particular region. Ne? So when we play solidarity with West Papuan people, we should directly link their struggle with ours here.
The fact that the West Papuans are oppressed or whatever is happening there, it's happening to them because they are black. And they are black because they are dispossessed, they are landless. Same as here. Whatever that is happening to us, it's happening because we are black. We are black because we are landless, we are oppressed. So to us, that's how we relate to West Papua.
Now the sunlight comes down, calls flowers from the ground. The world just turns round, and they're killing everybody that's brown. a savior is yet to be found. Hey, now the sunlight comes down, find my intelligence. This land I call it home, 'cause it's the same as me, down to my bone. Now the sunlight comes down, electromagnetic energy. The birds and all the trees, they were all born from love and peace. Yeah, love and peace. Now the sunlight comes down, and these humans all hate each other. They seem to not know that they all came from the stars. From the stars. Now I'm searching for horizon, but the sun is stuck in hell. And I heard
stationary, in a state of becoming but never being, standing on static concrete barrier of history when mentioning for it stands on stolen land and silent voices. A hobo, dirty hobo, rejected, denounced as subhuman, dragged on the mud of servitude, dehumanized before and for civilization, while the clergy sing hymns of how I was born a sinner, hungry, starving for self, searching for syllables on muted mouths of my ancestors, booked and sentenced by foreign laws. At a T-junction of life, with open hands and searching eyes, looking for my forebearers' footprints on short sands of history, only to conclude that they were long washed away by Western waves. I am a street kid, born with no name, for my history was hidden, and my home invaded and colonized. Pungent with marginalization, I'm a fat no one would dare claim. Prisoner in my own homeland, stripped of my heritage, my culture. I stand naked before my tormentors, crying to the deaf world, the world blind to our just cause. How we long to raise the morning star, Madenga Papua, Madenga Papua. Our mother is water, now with mass graves and shallow graves. I have buried my mother's sons and daughters, while our fathers and sons bury their heads, turn into shadows who lie dead on the ground that forever bleeds. For our dear mother, West Papua, who's raped every day by jellyfish Indonesian settlers, under the pretense act of free choice, an atrocious act condoned by the powers that be and accommodated by our silence.